Vertebrates are the advanced group of organisms on the planet Earth. The size of the vertebrates is larger than invertebrates. All animals possess strong and flexible vertebral column with chain of cylindrical bones. They are coelomate, triploblastic and bilaterally symmetrical. Circulation is closed type. Body is well segmented. Internal skeleton is well developed. Nervous system has well developed brain. Vertebrates are classified into five classes, namely Pisces, Amphibia, Reptilia, Aves, Mammalia. All are aquatic forms. The body is streamlined and boat-like. Skin is covered with scales as exoskeleton. The internal endoskeleton is made up of either cartilages or bones. Cartilages are tough but flexible tissues which are commonly seen in shark. Bony fishes have strong, tough bones, example, Cattla. They respire with the help of gills. Gills are covered on either sides by lid-like structures called as operculum. Heart is two-chambered with one auricle and one ventricle. They are poikilotherms having fluctuating body temperature. They may be oviparous and viviparous. Amphibians live both on land as well as water. Body is divided into head and trunk. Body is covered by a moist and slimy skin which helps for respiration. The heart is three-chambered with two auricles and one ventricle. Respiration is carried out by lungs and skin, but tadpoles respire with gills. They are poikilotherms having fluctuating body temperature. Fertilization is external. They are oviparous, that is, they lay eggs. Life cycle shows complete metamorphosis. Frogs, toads and salamanders are the example of amphibians. Characters: toad, frog. Skin: rough and watery. Moist and smooth. Tooth: toothless, seen only in upper jaw. Hind legs: short, long. Web: absent, present in hind feet. Time spent in water: spends little time, spends more time. They are creeping or crawling terrestrial animals. Body is covered with dry skin or epidermal scales. A thin tympanic membrane represents the ear. Heart is three-chambered with two auricles and one ventricle. Respiration is carried out by lungs. They are oviparous. The development is direct and young ones resemble their parents and no metamorphosis is seen. They are poikilotherms. Snakes, turtles, lizards are good examples for reptiles. Characteristic feature of birds is wings, which is a folim modification. Body is covered by feathers. Nose and mouth cluster to form a beak. Bones are hollow and filled with air called pneumatic bones. The hind limbs are modified and used for walking, swimming or clasping. They have four-chambered heart with two auricles and two ventricles. They are homeotherms with constant body temperature. Fertilization is internal. They are oviparous. Eggs possess thick shell called cladoic eggs. Egg contains large amount of yolk for embryonic development. Flying birds: pigeon, crow and sparrow. Flightless birds: ostrich, penguin, emu and cassowary. Characteristic feature of mammals is milk producing glands called mammary glands. Body is covered by skin with hair, sweat glands and oil glands. They have a ear lobe called ear pinnae and different types of teeth called heterodont. A special muscular partition in between thorax and abdomen region called diaphragm is seen only in mammals. They have four-chambered heart with two auricles and two ventricles. Respiration is carried out by lungs. They are homeotherms with constant body temperature. Fertilization is internal. They are viviparous, giving birth to young ones and feed them milk. Rat, cat, whale, dolphin, elephant, monkey and man are examples of mammals. Bat is the only flying mammal. India's biodiversity is enormous. There are 2000 species of fishes, 182 species of amphibians, 453 species of reptiles, 1200 species of birds and 350 species of mammals in India. India is ranked within the top 10 countries in the world as far as the biodiversity of vertebrates are concerned. Difference between invertebrates and vertebrates are as follows. Invertebrates, vertebrates. No backbone. Distinct backbone is seen. Both unicellular and multicellular form are seen. Only multicellular animals are seen. Locomotory organs are different, such as flagella, pseudopodia, cilia, setae, parapodia, etc. Locomotory organs are always two pairs of limbs. They may be free living or parasites. All organisms are free living and no parasitic forms. Organ systems are simple. Organ systems are complex and well organized. Animals reproduce either sexually or asexually. Animals reproduce only by sexual methods. In this topic, you have learnt: the vertebrates are the advanced group of organisms with strong vertebral column, endoskeleton, brain, true coelom, triploblastic layers, and bilaterally symmetrical body. They are classified into five classes, and the first class species are aquatic, poikilotherms, having streamlined body with scales as a covering. They have two-chambered heart, respire with gills. They may be oviparous or viviparous. Amphibians live dual life on land and water. They have three-chambered heart, respire with lungs and skin. They are oviparous with metamorphic life cycle. Reptiles are terrestrial, poikilothermic animals with dry skin. They have three-chambered heart, respire with lungs, having egg-laying habit. Aves are homeotherms with beak, wings and feathers. Bones are hollow, called pneumatic bones. They have four-chambered heart, respire with lungs. Their fertilization is internal but lay cladoic eggs with large yolk content. Mammals are homeotherms with mammary glands, pinnae, hair on the skin, diaphragm for respiratory mechanism. They have four-chambered heart, respire with lungs. Their fertilization is internal and viviparous. India's biodiversity is enormous and ranked within the top 10 countries in the world in vertebrate population.
At the end of this topic, you will be able to analyze the merits and demerits of asexual reproduction, discuss the types of asexual reproduction occurring in lower organisms, recall the steps involved in the conjugation of paramecium. Asexual reproduction has both advantages and disadvantages. Let us discuss the merits and demerits of asexual reproduction. Merits: only one parent is involved and all the offsprings are identical to their parent. This property is exploited by the humans to produce strains of organisms with desired characters. Demerits: since the genetic variation is negligible, the risk of extinction of a species becomes greater. Let us now discuss the types of asexual reproduction in different organisms, starting with fission. This method of reproduction is commonly found in unicellular organisms like bacteria and Euglena. Let us take bacteria as an example to discuss the fission. During fission, the parent cell elongates and is subjected to mitotic division. Nucleus of the parent cell elongates and divides into two equal halves. A constriction appears from the cell wall towards the center, dividing the cytoplasm. The constriction grows deeper and deeper, and once complete, it divides the cytoplasm. This process of division of a single parent cell into two daughter cells is called binary fission. The most common type of asexual reproduction found in yeast is budding. Let us see the steps involved in the formation of budding in yeast. The cell wall of the vegetative cell becomes thin at the corner, forming a soft zone. Slowly, this soft zone protrudes and bulges out into a small bud. Nucleus of the parent cell undergoes mitotic division and is divided into two equal halves. One of the nuclei will enter into the bud. A constriction starts to appear between the parent cell and the bud. The constriction grows deeper and finally the bud pinches off into a daughter cell. The parent cell continues this process to produce a chain of buds which can grow into new yeast cells. Sporulation is a common type of asexual reproduction found in fungi. It is the process of formation of spores. The type of spore is different in different species of fungi. Penicillium reproduces by conidiospores and mucor reproduces by sporangiospores. Let us see the reproducing structures and method of sporulation in mucor. The plant body of mucor is mycelium. Mycelium is made of thread-like structures called hyphae. During sporulation, some of the hyphae grow erect and produce a sac-like structure called sporangium at their tips. The nucleus of sporangia undergoes several mitotic divisions to produce a large number of spores called sporangiospores. When the wall layer of sporangium breaks, these sporangiospores are liberated. Sporangiospores are microscopic, unicellular, and reproductive units that germinate into new vegetative hyphae of mucor. Fragmentation is the simplest type of asexual reproduction that occurs in lower organisms. Hyphae of the fungal mycelium divide into many fragments. These fragments reach a suitable substratum. Under favorable conditions, these fragments give rise to a new individual organism. Majority of the animals undergo sexual reproduction because new characters are produced in offspring only during sexual reproduction. Male sex organs produced by animals are called testes, and female sex organs are called ovaries. Gametes produced by the male sex organ are spermatozoa or sperms. Gametes produced in female sex organ are ova or egg. Sperms are always smaller in size and large in number compared to ovum. Sperms are motile, they can move freely. Ova are non-motile. Fusion of sperm and ovum is said to be fertilization, which results in zygote. Zygote develops into a new organism. Sexual reproduction in paramecium, unicellular protozoa, takes place through conjugation. Paramecium has two types of nucleus. They are macronucleus and micronucleus. Macronucleus is larger in size and is responsible for vegetative functions. Micronucleus is smaller in size and is involved in conjugation. Paramecium undergoes conjugation only when the animal has become weak and inactive due to repeated binary fission. Conjugation in paramecium takes place in 5 steps. The organism undergoes changes at each step. Step 1. Formation of cytoplasmic bridge. 2 conjugants come close and unite. The pellicle and outer covering dissolves and cytoplasm of the 2 paramecia becomes continuous through the part where the pellicle is dissolved. This is called a cytoplasmic bridge. Step 2. Formation of pronuclei. The macronucleus disappears. The micronucleus undergoes meiosis to form 4 haploid daughter micronuclei. Of these 4 micronuclei, 3 disappear and the remaining micronucleus divides unequally into 2 nuclei. The smaller one is male pronucleus and the larger one is a female pronucleus. Step 3. Formation of synchaeron. The male pronucleus of one conjugant moves through the cytoplasmic bridge into the other conjugant and fuses with the female pronucleus. The fused nucleus is known as synchaeron. Then, the two conjugants separate and are then called ex-conjugants. Step 4. Formation of macro and micronuclei in ex-conjugants. In each ex-conjugants, synchaeron divides thrice by mitosis and forms 8 nuclei. Of these 8, 4 develop into macronuclei, 1 into micronucleus, and the remaining 3 will disappear. Step 5. Formation of daughter paramecia. Each ex-conjugant with a single micronucleus and 4 micronuclei divides twice and forms 4 daughter paramecia. 4 macronuclei of ex-conjugants are distributed to the 4 daughter paramecia, but the single micronucleus divides along with the ex-conjugants. Thus, each of the 4 daughter paramecia gets 1 micro and 1 macronucleus. By conjugation, single paramecium produces 4 daughter paramecia. In this topic you have learnt, binary fission is commonly found in lower organisms such as bacteria and euglena. Yeast reproduces asexually by budding. Mycelium is made of thread-like structures called hyphae. Sporangiospores are microscopic, unicellular and reproductive units of mucor. Fragmentation is another method of asexual reproduction that occurs in fungi.
In higher organisms, two individuals of a species, male and female, are involved in sexual reproduction. The male reproductive organ is the testis, which produces the sperms. The female reproductive organ is the ovary, which produces the ova or eggs. At the end of this topic, you will be able to define what metamorphosis is, discriminate between complete and incomplete metamorphosis, explain the process of molting, describe the serial changes happening in complete metamorphosis. In the developmental process, the young ones which come out from the egg either resemble the adult or different from them. To attain the adult look, the young one has to undergo some changes. Metamorphosis is the process of a series of morphological, anatomical, and physiological changes of a young one to get transformed into an adult. There are two types of metamorphosis, called incomplete and complete. Incomplete metamorphosis has 3 distinct stages, like the egg, nymph, and the adult stage, and they go through gradual changes. The young one partially resembles the adult. Complete metamorphosis has 4 distinct stages, like an embryo or egg, a larva, a pupa, and an imago or adult. The young one is completely different from the adult. The young one which was newly hatched resembles the adult except in size, wings, and reproductive organs. The nymphs hatched out from the egg undergoes successive moltings and reaches the adult stage. Molting was controlled by molting hormone or ecdysone or juvenile hormones. Molting hormones are secreted by the neurosecretory cells of the brain of an insect. Egg to nymph and nymph to adult. Grasshopper and mayfly undergo incomplete metamorphosis. The young one in complete metamorphosis is completely different from the adult. The egg gives out the worm-like larva called caterpillar. Caterpillars are voracious eaters and they feed on leaves and increase the size. After increasing their size, they develop a cocoon around their body and goes to rest for further development. This stage is called as pupa stage, which is completely absent in incomplete metamorphosis. After a period of rest, the adult or imago emerges out of the cocoon. Egg to larva, larva to pupa, and pupa to adult. Butterfly and silk moth undergo complete metamorphosis. In this topic, you have learned, in the developmental process, the young ones may or may not resemble the adult. To attain the adult look, the young one undergoes a series of morphological, anatomical, and physiological changes called metamorphosis. There are two types of metamorphosis called incomplete and complete. Incomplete metamorphosis has three stages, like the egg, nymph, and the adult stage, and complete metamorphosis has four stages, namely an embryo or egg, a larva, a pupa, and an imago or adult. Grasshopper and mayfly undergo incomplete metamorphosis, and butterfly and silk moth undergo complete metamorphosis. Molting is common in incomplete metamorphosis, which is controlled by molting hormone secreted by neurosecretory cells. In butterfly life cycle, the ugly-looking caterpillars eats enormously and hide into cocoon and form a pupa and later emerges as a beautiful butterfly.